Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, welcome and thanks so much for joining me for today's video. As we approach the holiday season, I thought it would be fun to do my top 10 vanilla fragrances for the cold weather months. Vanilla is one of my all-time favorite notes to wear. I'm really excited to take you through some of my favorites today. We have everything from, you know, lower end, more budget-friendly items to your more niche fragrances as well. So the first one on my list is the Seven Virtues Vanilla Woods. As you can see by the bottle, I've made quite a dent in this. It used to be one of my favorite kind of signature scents for the fall and winter months. I used to wear this one to work all the time. It is a huge compliment getter. If you do like to get compliments on your fragrance, if you wear fragrance for that reason, this is a really good one. So I'll go ahead and take you through the notes of this fragrance. The top note is pear, the mid is rose, and the base is vanilla, amber, and caramel. So from the first sniff here, oh my gosh, it is just such a sweet and comforting fragrance. So perfect for cold weather months. Like, I love to spray this on like my scarf and my clothing. It just makes everything smell so good. It has great longevity, a pretty good sillage, but it's not like offensive by any means. The first sniff, it's super sweet. And the top note is meant to be pear. However, this isn't like your just picked pear. It's not like, you know, fresh and juicy. It's more like a flambéed or caramelized pear. It's sweet and ripe and mouth-watering. Definitely caramelized, super sweet. This is definitely a gourmand fragrance. If you are afraid of sweet scents, this is definitely not gonna be for you. You might as well just turn this video off because a lot of these are gourmand fragrances, but if you like that, then stick around. Yeah, this one is really, really good. This is like a sweet, cozy, casual fragrance. During the winter months, it is such an easy reach. You know, if you're wearing just like a cozy sweater and a pair of jeans or leggings, like this is what you want to pick up when you need something a little bit like unassuming, but still really delicious. I also like to wear this one to bed, a comforting, cozy fragrance. The dry down on this is vanilla and caramel, but I am getting a touch of amber and maybe like a smoky note, which I think is where the Vanilla Woods name kind of comes from. To me, this is pretty linear compared to other fragrances that, you know, have a lot of change throughout wear. This, to me, is pretty linear. The vanilla is the same in the top note and it's the same in the base, and there's not a ton of change happening throughout the fragrance, but still it's amazing. This is such a pretty fragrance. It's again cozy, pretty, feminine, comforting. I would love to smell this on my friends and family. I think this would be a safe gift if who you're buying for enjoys sweeter or gourmand fragrances. The next vanilla fragrance that I want to share is Vanille Coco. I have been through so many of these bottles. I typically just purchase the small little like travel size bottles for this fragrance in particular because it is one that I've worn for years. I just like to chuck it in my purse and spray it on throughout the day. It is an eau de toilette, so it doesn't stay on the skin quite as long as like an eau de parfum, but this is such an awesome vanilla fragrance. This one you could really wear year-round because it does have a little bit of a tropical quality to it. So if you wanted to wear it in the spring or summer, or maybe like in a hot weather climate, you definitely could. This one, it reminds me of sugar cookie or like cupcake kind of scent, so it is a nice one to wear, especially in the holiday months. So I'm just gonna go ahead and spray it. It's been a while since I've worn this one. Oh my gosh, this is such a sugar bomb. Like, if you are familiar with other sugar bombs like Pink Sugar or Love Don't Be Shy, like this is along that level, but I almost want to say sweeter. Okay, so the notes for Coco Vanille are whipped cream, banana, and heliotrope. Middle notes are vanilla and coconut, and the base notes are the same, so vanilla and coconut again. Oh my gosh, this is so good. Okay, let me take you through. So top, I 100% smell the cream. This is like a very delectable, fluffy, creamy sort of fragrance. I do get maybe like a hint of the banana, but if you're interested in more of a vanilla banana, I believe the brand also does like Vanille Banane, so that might be of interest to you. And you definitely get the heliotrope. It gives it a little bit of this like powdery component to it, which is really nice. And then as it begins to settle down, you do get more of that like vanilla and coconut. It is super edible. When I used to wear this, I used to wear this to work all the time, and I would always get compliments on it. It actually smells like you've just baked something like cupcakes or cookies. Smelling it on paper, it kind of reminds me of like a vanilla coconut kind of like milkshake, almost like a pina colada, but taking away the pineapple. It's really, really delicious. I know it's a little bit more like tropical than the rest of the items that I have on my list, but because it does smell a lot like baked goods, it's a very like comforting fragrance. I think this is a great fragrance to wear during the winter months. It also is really sweet, could be a little bit cloying. So again, wearing it during colder weather is probably a smarter take for this specific fragrance. To no one's surprise, the next one on our list here is Kiali's Vanilla 28. Would it really be a vanilla video if we didn't mention this fragrance? I don't think so. I think this is one of the best and most likable vanilla fragrances to come out in the last decade. I know a lot of people think that vanilla is like dryer sheets and, you know, candles for scenting your home, but not this one. This one is a lot more complex than that and way more delicious than a dryer sheet. Let me go ahead and take you through the notes here. We have notes of vanilla orchid and jasmine in the top, middle notes of brown sugar and tonka bean, and base notes of amber, musk, amber wood, and patchouli. So the top notes to me on this fragrance are surprisingly sharp, but don't let it fool you. This scent definitely does a 180 in terms of its scent profile. So it starts out with like a peppery vanilla orchid and jasmine. And again, it's a little bit sharp, especially if you are spraying or you're smelling exactly where you sprayed it. It's different when you kind of smell it as like the sillage around you. It's a little bit more like warm and sweet, but if you're smelling exactly where you sprayed it, it does come across a little bit more sharp. The mid is like a combination of that vanilla orchid and the tonka and caramelized brown sugar. It's becoming sweeter, it's getting creamier, but we haven't yet reached the pinnacle. The best part of this fragrance to me is absolutely the dry down. So the base does have notes of patchouli, but unless you're smelling exactly where you sprayed it on yourself, I'm not really able to detect it. The overall sillage of this fragrance is giving you sweet, delicious, gourmand, and warm. The vanilla in here is just beautiful. You definitely get vanilla and brown sugar and amber in the dry down. This is almost like a vanilla cake that has been soaked in some sort of brown sugar syrup nectary goodness. It's super feminine and sweet and just an amazing scent for fall and winter. So the next fragrance we have here is a nice break from our gourmand scents. This is more vanilla with a hint of powder. This is Maison Francis Kurkdjian's Gentle Fluidity Gold. I'll go ahead and I'll take you through the notes on this one. So we have vanilla, amber, musk, woodsy notes, juniper berries, nutmeg, and coriander. This one is oh my gosh, it's so, so pretty. It is so nostalgic for me as well. This is vanilla with a hint of powder on the top. Like, it's a velvety vanilla with lots of musk, powdery musk on the top. It's a very 90s musk. It actually reminds me a lot of the scent profile of, I think it was the Body Shop's The White Musk. Very, very popular scent in the 90s. I feel like every powerful woman was wearing musk at that time. It was such an important scent. I have memories of growing up in Germany and the wife of this, you know, executive from Hewlett Packard that my family used to work for, she would wear her like black tights and red suits, and she would wear a fragrance that smelled so much like this. It just reminds me so much of the 90s. It's really, really beautiful though. So the dry down here is soft and vanillic with some freshness from the juniper berries. It's still very powdery. And then the deep dry down, it's still vanillic. It's more sweet vanillic with a touch of amber. This is soft and warm. It's mature, it's sophisticated. This to me is like warm, fuzzy cashmere sweaters with pearls and a glass of champagne. It is just so effortlessly elegant. It's a really gorgeous fragrance for the holiday season for sure. The next fragrance we have is Mancera's Black Vanilla. This scent really took me by surprise. I only have just sampled it in my collection and I'm very surprised by how much I liked it. To me, it sounded like it was going to be a very kind of floral vanilla, and it is floral, but the dry down is like candy. Let me go ahead and take you through the notes here. So we have notes of blackcurrant, white peach, coconut, bergamot, and middle notes of violet, jasmine, rose, and base notes of Madagascar vanilla and white musk. So again, you would think that it'd be very like fruity, floral, kind of vanilla, maybe some musk in there. So this to me starts off as a very clean vanilla with some fruitiness mixed in. So you get a little bit of blackcurrant. It's not this juicy dewberry blackcurrant that you get in Mixed Emotions, a little bit more of like a dry, bitter blackcurrant, a lot of peach. I don't really get any coconut here, but it's definitely vanilla with some fruit. And then very quickly starts to dry down and you get more of those floral notes. As it dries down, you get a lot of the jasmine, you get this kind of like powdery soapiness quality to it. This is a very fun scent to experience because I felt like after the first hour at least of wearing this fragrance, every time I sniffed my wrist, I would experience something new. New notes, changing of notes. The dry down, which we will get to, was just unbelievable. But yeah, this is very clean, floral, vanilla scent, slightly powdery, and it does get a lot sweeter in the dry down. So if you like vanilla and jasmine and violet, you are definitely going to like this fragrance. And if you like sweet, candied violet, then you will love this fragrance. I think that this is marketed as a unisex fragrance, but to me, it is very, very feminine leaning. Not to say that, you know, men couldn't wear this as well, but it is very feminine leaning, at least to me and my nose. This reminds me of maybe walking into Marie Antoinette's clubhouse or whatever you call her house that she had just off of Versailles where she used to hang out. That's what I'm talking about here. It's like walking there and there's just flowers everywhere and cakes everywhere and you're smelling the icing and the flowers. The vanilla here is, it's like a crystallized kind of sugar. It's sweet and like sugar flower decorations on a cake or like candied violets. That's definitely what I'm getting here. Oh my gosh, it's so good. As this begins to dry down even further, this becomes like candy sweet on your skin with maybe just like the littlest hint of that violet sort of floral note. The smell reminds me of the taste of white jelly beans. Not like a gourmet jelly belly, but like just a traditional white jelly bean. I think that traditionally that's like a vanilla pineapple flavor. There's not really any pineapple in a white jelly bean, but it's that sort of vanilla taste in the form of a scent in this fragrance. Even when I woke up, you know, 8 hours later, I could still smell this fragrance on my wrist and the deep dry down was insane. It is like this mouth-watering, delicious vanilla marshmallow hard candy fragrance. So this is such a beautiful one. I hope that you get to experience it. Next up here, we have another Mancera fragrance. It is Royal Vanilla. I only again have a sample of this one, but it is beautiful. The notes on this one are Madagascar vanilla, amber, patchouli, and violet. So this to me, when you first spray it, reminds me a lot of Montale's Intense Cafe. You're getting that sort of coffee, cocoa, jammy rose fragrance. However, I'm not really getting any coffee in this. It's a lot more vanilla heavy. It's more like a syrupy, sticky, sweet, resinous vanilla, especially because of the amber in this fragrance. This is such a sensual fragrance to me. I think this would be an amazing date night or night out type of fragrance. I can guarantee that if you wore this, people would be turning their heads looking to see who is wearing this fragrance, because it is just, like I said, it is so sensual, an amazing vanilla fragrance as well. It is definitely sweet, so a great fragrance for the colder months. So if you're looking for something to wear to a holiday party to maybe get someone's attention, this is a great option. Next on my list of vanillas is the House of Ouds What About Pop. This is a sweet, lactonic, vanilla caramel fragrance. This one is so good for fall and winter. Go ahead and read you the notes here. So the top notes we have are popcorn, caramel, and hawthorn. Middle notes of whipped cream, Madagascar vanilla, and night blooming cereus. And base notes of ebony, benzoin, ambergris, musk, and Madagascar vetiver. I really prefer the notes of the top to mid. In the base or dried down, it does get a little bit more masculine smelling. I like to just kind of reapply this as soon as I start to experience the base because I do love the top notes so much. So you're getting that caramel popcorn on the top and it is buttery and sweet. I really love any fragrances and I seek out fragrances with the caramel popcorn note in it because growing up one of my favorite fragrances, signature scent of mine, was the 2005 version of Miss Dior Cherie, which had strawberry leaf and caramel popcorn. And I think those scents are just so beautiful and so unique. So I really love this fragrance for those notes alone. I really love this fragrance. I think it's super unique. The caramel popcorn is quite realistic, but you have enough of other notes to keep this in the perfume territory as opposed to completely edible on the skin or too cloying. It is just such an interesting fragrance. So if you like the sounds of vanilla and caramel popcorn, this is a great one to try. So next on my list, we have Tom Ford's Tobacco Vanille. I do have a decant of this that I've been making my way through. It is a great vanilla fragrance, but it's also just overall an amazing fragrance for fall, winter. I love this on my husband, but I also love it on myself because on me, I get to experience more of the notes. I also find that this one transforms a little bit sweeter on my skin, whereas it's more spicy on him. So I'll go ahead and take us through the notes here. So we have top notes of tobacco leaf and spice, middle notes of vanilla, cacao, tonka bean, and tobacco blossom, and base notes of dried fruits and woody notes. So at first sniff, this was like smoky root beer, but as it begins to settle on your skin, you get the earthy, rich tobacco, and you get this really yummy, warm, spicy note as well. It's a very rich fragrance. And then as it begins to dry down and settle a little more, in the mid, you experience more of the vanilla, and you also get some of the powderiness from the tonka bean and the cacao as well. About an hour in, this becomes sweet and beautiful. It is such a masterpiece blend between the tobacco and the vanilla. It's really interesting too, because you are getting the tobacco in the top, the mid, and the base, but this fragrance really changes as it dries on the skin. The deep dry down on this is vanilla and tobacco and dried fruits. And I really love a dried fruit note. I think it makes fragrances so unique, and it kind of makes me want to keep smelling my wrist. It's one of those notes. I had the same experience trying, I think it was the Jo Malone fragrances that came out in the summer that were all sort of like pantry, like English pantry inspired or like preserve inspired. They definitely use dried fruit notes in a lot of those fragrances, and those were really good as well. In Tobacco Vanille, my nose interprets the dried fruit note as like chocolate covered plums. And the Tobacco Vanille is again that sort of like root beer float with vanilla ice cream. It's fluffy and creamy and cloud-like. Again, this is an amazing cold weather fragrance, and because of those dried fruit notes and the warm spices and the vanilla, I think this is an amazing festive fragrance, so great for wearing during Christmas or for New Year's Eve. I know this is a very common fragrance out there, but for a reason, it's so well-liked. I think this is a masterpiece fragrance and one of my favorite vanillas. Okay, next up on my list here, we have another masterpiece of fragrance. It is Zirjoff's Lyra. Before I get into how good it is, I need to warn you that this is a fragrance that right now is like sold out everywhere. I believe you can still buy maybe the 100 ml bottles on some of the discounter websites. The 30 mls are pretty much sold out everywhere. I'm not really ready to spend $400 on a single bottle of fragrance. I used to do that all the time, but I'm looking to expand my collection, so trying to just buy the smaller bottles right now, but I would buy the 100 ml if it wasn't Christmas time, that's for sure. This really is a work of art. And the last fragrance that I have on my list is actually not so bad of a dupe if you can find the 10th fragrance on my list. So again, getting into Lyra here, let me take you through the notes. Oh, it's so good. Okay, we have top notes of blood orange, bergamot, and lavender. Middle notes of cinnamon, licorice, and jasmine, and base notes of caramel, vanilla, and musk. So this to me smells like lavender, vanilla, chocolate, and orange. It really does smell like an orange cake or something. It's really good. So the vanilla and the lavender and the chocolate together remind me a lot of the Lush fragrance. I think it's called Sleepy. It comes in a lot of different products throughout Lush. I think there's like a bath bomb now, there's maybe a shower gel, there's definitely a cream. I'm a big fan of the body lotion. It's that kind of like vanilla, chocolatey lavender. It's a lot more rich and sweet and warm. And I'm also getting that fresh blood orange. So this is like peeling into an orange and you're getting that spritz of citrus everywhere. It is a combination of those two scents together. I think that's a pretty good description. The lavender note stays on me for quite a while and it's very comforting and creamy, but then this turns into more of a vanilla, orange spice cake type of gourmand. The orange note that you got in the beginning, a very citrusy and sharp and warm, it ends up kind of leaning into more of this vanillic, sweet, like Meyer lemon type of scent. It is similar to the other fragrance that I'm gonna talk about in just a moment. This has great sillage as well. When I was working from home, all I was doing was working on the laptop, but just from that small little movement of like typing, I was getting like huge wafts of this beautiful fragrance. So this is a more mature gourmand, I think because of the lavender note, it leans a little bit more mature, but the dry down or the deep dry down, it is pure vanilla and caramel. This is like vanilla caramel buttercream on top of a citrus cake. It is so beautiful. No wonder it's sold out everywhere. You can't find it. Longevity is amazing. I sprayed it on myself at 8 o'clock in the morning and I could still smell it like 12 hours later. Great fall winter scent, amazing for the holidays, super festive. It's gourmand without being juvenile. I can't say enough great things about this. I cannot wait to buy myself a bottle. All right, so the last fragrance on my list here is Zara, a sweet pastry in Paris. I believe this was a limited edition fragrance from Zara, but you can still buy it through a lot of retailers, eBay, Poshmark, that sort of thing. They did come in quite big bottles for a very small price. So if you can get your hands on it, it is a not so bad dupe for Zirjoff's Lyra. I think there's a lot of commonalities between the fragrances. It's been a while since I've sprayed this one. So let me just go ahead and put on a tester here. So this one has notes of lemon, sugarcane, and vanilla. It starts off a little bit juvenile to me. It reminds me of sort of a fragrance that I used to wear when I was maybe in like middle school or early high school. So the top note on this fragrance is lemon, and it is a super sharp, sour, tart lemon. This is the sort of like lemon that you would use in like a lemon curd that you're going to put into pastries. Super, super sharp. It does begin to dry down a little bit and you get more of that sugar cane. So it's a nice mix between sugar and lemon. You definitely have, you know, thoughts of walking into a patisserie and seeing all of these, you know, brown glazed pastries, and there's lots of different fillings and there's like this sort of brown sugar baked note in the air. This is what I kind of get from this fragrance. Natalie Larson is the nose of this fragrance. You may be familiar with her work from Black Opium by YSL. She's also done Oriana and Meliora by Parfum de Marly. So I knew this would be a pretty good fragrance just based on, you know, her creations. In the dry down, it does remind me a little bit more of Lyra because you're getting more of the sugarcane and vanilla mixed together. It's more of that like creamy buttercream type of fragrance with a little bit of the lemon in the background. So it is not full on a dupe for Lyra, but they are quite similar in their dry downs. Oh my gosh, yeah. Now that this fragrance has dried down more, it definitely reminds me of Zirjoff Lyra. Just the vanilla mixed with the lemon is just very reminiscent of that fragrance. So I could definitely see myself wearing this one to the office. It's a nice mix of lemon and vanilla. It's very inoffensive. It's a pleasant smell. I could see myself wearing this to go grab, you know, tea and a pastry with a friend during a winter blustery day, or even just wearing around the house because it's kind of relaxing. I could see myself, you know, wearing this while baking or maybe sitting on the couch watching a movie and stringing some popcorn and some garland for the tree. This is a really beautiful vanilla fragrance, a bit of freshness from the lemon as well, and you know, a kind of close dupe for Lyra, at least in the dry down. Again, not spot on. Lyra is a masterpiece, but this one is, you know, does come close, especially if you're not able to get your hands on Lyra. This is a good one to try out anyway. All right, everyone, that has wrapped up our 10 vanilla fragrances for today. I hope that you enjoyed. If you did, please make sure to give this video a thumbs up and consider subscribing to my channel, and I hope to see you in the next one. Bye for now.